Hi everybody, it's Butterfly here from the Cooper Center for Environmental Learning, and today I'd like to look at some of the similarities and differences between moths and butterflies. So next time you're talking about them or you're looking at one, you'll know what's going on, and they have some ways that will help you identify which one you're looking at. So I wanted to start with the similarities because both moths and butterflies belong to the order Lepidoptera, which means scaled wing. So they both do have a bunch of teeny, teeny scales making up their wings. And they both go through metamorphosis, where they drastically change through each phase of their life. So from egg to caterpillar. Now, as a caterpillar, you can only tell them apart by learning what the caterpillars of each butterfly and moth group look like. So that's a great opportunity to know and grow as you go along. Now, some butterflies and moths, to warn potential predators to stay away, might have large eye spots on them to make them look like scary animals to frighten predators. While some butterflies and moths don't like the attention and want to blend in with their environment, so there are butterflies and moths that look like leaves or tree bark or something that's going to be natural that they can blend into. Now, butterflies and moths also use their antennae for similar purposes, which includes smell, finding their way, and balance. Now, I'd like to look at some of the differences. First off, there are many, many more species of moths on the planet than there are butterflies. So I'm talking about 160,000 species or different types of moths on the planet versus about 20,000 species of butterflies. Also, the moth wing, unlike butterfly wings, have a structure called a frenulum, which joins their forewing, so their front wing, to their hind wing, their back wing, so that the wings can work in unison, so work together at the same time during flight. Now, butterflies' wings go up and down, and there's all four just floating about, and they kind of make a figure eight pattern during flight. So the way they fly is slightly different. Now, moth antennae are often feathery, and without a knob at the end. And with these large feathered antennae, moths tend to have a much more powerful sense of smell than butterflies. Some moths can smell miles away. What's that way over there? Now, each of those feathers are like a teeny smell receptor. Butterfly antennae, on the other hand, are long and thin and end with a knob at the tip, or a golf ball, however you want to think of it. Now, butterflies, to get a little extra nutrients, will have what I like to call puddle parties, where a bunch of butterflies gather, and it's called puddling, and they drink up mud or rotting fruit to get some of that sodium and minerals into their diet. So that's where they socialize, hang out, catch up on the gossip, whereas very few moths do this. Butterflies are primarily diurnal, which means they fly or they're active during the daytime, and moths generally are nocturnal, meaning they fly or are active during the night. However, there are moths that are diurnal, like the buck moth, and there are butterflies that fly at dawn or dusk. Similarly, size and color aren't the best indicator of whether you're looking at a moth or butterfly, right? Because you can have very small butterflies and very huge moths, and very small moths and very large butterflies. And though most butterflies have more vibrant colors, there are several that have muted colors or they're trying to blend into their habitat. Now, the flowers that are visited by moths are typically white flowers or flowers that are dull in color. These flowers are ones that open late afternoon or night. They produce a lot of nectar. So these are flowers like the yucca succulent or gardenias might be where you see some moths. And then butterflies typically visit flowers that are more brightly colored, red, pink, orange, yellow. These flowers are open during the day. They also produce a lot of nectar, but they're mainly found in clusters of like small flowers. So this is like milkweed, maybe spirea. You'll see butterflies on flowers like that. Now, butterflies usually, when they land, rest with their wings closed, while moths, when they land, usually rest with their wings open. So that's a great indicator of which one you're looking at as well. Now, this is a big one. Both butterflies and moths go through metamorphosis, right? Egg to caterpillar to the pupa stage. But the way they construct the things to protect them in that stage is different. Moths tend to construct cocoons and butterflies construct chrysalises. And they're not the same thing. What? Hold the phone. Those two phrases are always interchanged between the two, but they're totally two different processes. Now, a cocoon is an external structure constructed by the larva, the caterpillar, to protect themselves during the pupal stage. So the moth caterpillars spin cocoons of silk around themselves before the final molt. This silk hardens into their protective casing and allows them to go through their metamorphosis relatively undisturbed. Now, a butterfly makes a chrysalis, and a chrysalis is the actual hardened body of the butterfly pupa. So the outside of the chrysalis is the exoskeleton, or the skin of the pupa. So a butterfly caterpillar still has to spin a small disc of silk to attach itself to the underside of a leaf or twig, but then that caterpillar sheds its skin one last time as the pupa emerges and the outer surface of the pupa hardens into that protective shell. And that's how they go through their metamorphosis. And usually that color or shape tends to blend into its surroundings. So those were the similarities and differences I had for you for moths and butterflies. I hope you all enjoyed. I hope you learned something new. I've also attached a paper that has a bunch of insects on it, and you can go and try to find the moths and butterflies. Have a great day. Go do something you enjoy.